Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to explain how you can count how many digits are odd and how many digits are even in a given number, right? So before starting, if you go to a detail or description of this video, you will find various links related to playlists. So you can watch them. Those playlists are related to various videos. Based on programming. So now I'm explaining how you can implement the logic for this. So for example, we have a number 1053. 1053. So we need to count how many digits are even and how many digits are odd in this number. So this number is containing four digits. So we need to take each digit individually from this number. And then we will divide that digit by 2. If that digit is completely divisible by 2, then it is even, otherwise odd. So here you can see 1 is odd, 5 is odd, and 3 is odd. So total odd digits are 3 and even digit is 1. Now if we take another number, so let's say number is 2, 4, 3, 6. Number is 2, 4, 3, 6. So here 2, 4 and 6, these are even and 3 is odd. So if we take this example, so here you can see odd number is 1 and even is 3. So after this explanation, now I am going to implement a program. So you will learn how we can implement a C program for this requirement. So these are the variables that will be required, NA, C1, C2. So C1, let's say, will be storing even count and C2 will be storing odd count. Or you can take even and odd as a name of variable. So that depends upon your requirement, how you can use the variable names. Then a printf, enter a number, then scanf, %d, %n. So the input number will be stored inside this n variable. Now we can apply a loop. Inside that loop, we need to apply if condition so that we can check whether the digit is even or odd. So I am implementing a loop. So here you can see its condition is n greater than 0. So first I am implementing the logic, and then I will explain that logic with the example that we took earlier. So let's say a equals to n modulus 10. So now I am applying if a modulus 2 double equals to 0. So I am counting c1 plus plus, else I am counting c2 plus plus, and then n equals to n by 10. So this is the loop that I am going to use for solving this problem. So now I am taking one example. So let's say our number is 2436. C1 is 0, C2 is 0, right? Now start from here. So while n is greater than 0, so it is true, then n modulus 10. So whenever we divide a number by 10 and we want to receive its remainder, so remainder will be always last digit. So A will be having 6. Now we need to divide a by 2. So again, we are taking remainder. So if a modulus 2, its remainder is equals to 0. So this time a is 6. So 6 is completely divisible by 2. So here remainder will be 0. So 0 is equals to 0. So c1 will be counted as 1. C1 will be counted as 1. So if condition is true, so we will not move to else part. And here you can see I have not used curly braces. So if is having one statement, else is also having one statement, and this n equals to n by 10 is not related to if or else. So after completion of if else, this will execute always. So n is equals to n by 10. So value of n is 2436. So now if I divide it by 10, so its result will be 243. Because after 243, there will be 0.6. So if we are taking variable as of integer type, So 0.6 will be removed. So finally outcome is 243. Now repeat same process again and again. So again number is 243, which is greater than 0. Find the modulus. So this time modulus will be 3. Again divide A modulus 2. So 3 modulus 2, remainder will be 1. So this condition is false now. So you need to increase C2. So this time C2 will be 1. Now after completion of if else condition, then we came here. So n divided by 10. So n is 243. So it will remain 24. Now again check the condition. It is true. N modulus 10. So here this time A will receive 4. So 4 is completely divisible by 2. So remainder will be 0. So we need to increase C1. Then n by 10. So n will be having 2. Check this condition. It is true. 2 modulus 10. So A will be having 2 this time. So 2 modulus 2, remainder will be 0. So again C1 will be incremented. So it is 3. C2 is not incremented because condition is true. Then again divide n by 10. So this time n is 2. So 2 by 10, 0 point something. So this time n will be having 0. So here you can see now this loop will not repeat because n is 0 right now. And in C1 we have 3, in C2 we have 1. So C1 is related to even and C2 is related to odd. So here you can see both are having same values. So after completion of this loop, we can print even equals to %d, odd equals to %d. So for even we took C1, for odd we took C2. So C1 will print a value here, C2 will print value here, and even equals to the value 3, odd equals to the value 1 will be printed as output, and then you can close the main function. So this way I explained you how you can count how many digits are odd and how many digits are even in a given number. So inside while loop we used if else also. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you will find more than 1000 videos related to computer programming. So do watch them, follow my video and channel. Thank you for watching this video.